Ayala-controlled PHINMA Energy intending to spend $2 billion in the next 6 years to build up 2,000 megawatts of renewable electricity. Now, PHINMA Energy, as you mentioned earlier, which will be renamed as AC Energy Philippines, plans to partly fund its expansion program by doing a stock rights offering in the first or second quarter of next year, 2020. Mr. Eric Francia, President and CEO of PHINMA Energy, said the details of the plan would also address the potential dilution of the holdings of minority shareholders in the company due to a planned share swap. Details of that share swap and the stock rights offering would be finalized by October 9th. The share swap is meant to consolidate the assets of PHINMA Energy and AC Energy Inc., which is different from the planned name of PHINMA AC Energy Philippines, because AC Energy Inc. is the parent of both companies. Now, this is the main holding company of the Ayala Group's energy asset. PHINMA Energy is also seeking to increase its authorized capital stock to 24 billion pesos from 8 billion pesos, and this additional 16 billion in fresh shares will be used to partly fund the share swap. As a group, AC Energy plans to have around 5,000 megawatts of renewable energy capacity by 2025, and 2,000 megawatts of that will be onshore or in the Philippines, built or sourced in the Philippines under AC Energy Philippines, which is right now called PHINMA Energy. Francia explained renewable energy will be 50% of their total capacity, though he stopped short of giving a target for traditional power plants like coal, saying they want to limit investments in the thermal facilities, but would invest on an opportunistic basis. Also, Kathy, after the AC Energy Philippines stockholders meeting, or PHINMA Energy at ASM, they also held the annual stockholders meeting for PHINMA's the oil and oil exploration unit, PHINMA Oil and Geothermal, or PHINMA Geothermal. This is also a part of the PHINMA Group, which was acquired by Ayala Corp. And in that annual stockholders meeting, they also stated their plans to still pursue oil exploration or gas exploration projects here in the Philippines, especially in the service contract 55, which is offshore West Palawan. And they said that this project right now is just awaiting approval from regulators or from the Department of Energy on how they could appraise the potential reserves of gas and oil in that specific area. Kathy.
So Group's renewable push comes as oil spikes, presumably makes renewables a lot cheaper. But what did the executives there say about the oil price spike and how it impacts business altogether, because the Philippines still is a heavy oil importer?
Mm-hmm. Well, that's right, Kathy. Of course, that's still a big topic, a big issue for the Philippine energy sector. And however, for AC Energy, or for the whole energy arm of the Ayala Group, they're not too concerned over the impact, since most of the projects or the power facilities that they hold are on renewable as well as natural gas, which is a very little exposure to oil or diesel. However, they said that this still highlights the need for further oil exploration investments here in the Philippines, that's to ensure the energy security in Manila and the country. And they said that hopefully through PHINMA Petroleum and Geothermal, they'd be able to pursue more of that exploration activities. However, he said that for now they're still focused on renewable energy, and any oil exploration would be somehow secondary to that, and they're still studying further opportunities on that space.